unless you've been living under a rock, you know exactly what the BMW M5 is all about. On this edition of Test Drive, the latest version of that Bavarian road rocket. The BMW M5 was first shown at the Amsterdam Motor Show in 1984. It's remarkable what a simple letter number combination has come to signify in such a short period of time. Mention the name and nearly all people instantly know what it's come to represent. It's a seriously fast and adroit road rocket that doubles as a full-on family sedan. The cabin of this M5 is absolutely exquisite. Top-class materials, beautiful leather, two of the best seats you'll find in the industry, and all of the power toys, up to and including navigation and a very good audio system. There is, however, a pet peeve, and it has to do with the shifter. When you want to put this car in park, you leave it in gear and turn it off. The car then selects park. Well, most of the time. Sometimes it manages to select neutral. It warns you, but what a palaver you have to go through to put it back into park. I want a park button down here by the gear lever. That way, I can put it in park when I want to put it in park. The latest M5 is powered by a hellacious 4.4-litre twin-turbo V8. To say it produces enough power is an understatement. With the intercooled turbos blowing their not-so-little vanes out, it produces 560 horsepower. Now that is a big number. The torque, however, is what really grabs the driver's attention. All 500 pound-feet at just 1500 RPM. This means that from basically idle to redline, this engine is ready to give the riders a mighty boot in the pants whenever the throttle is prodded with purpose. It also equates to a very fast rest to 100k run of 4.3 seconds and a blindingly fast 80 to 120 kilometer an hour passing move of 3 seconds flat. Now obviously, if you've got that much power under the hood, you've got to have the right brakes. These M5 brakes are enormous. The rotors are about the size of a dustbin lid and they've got 6 piston calipers biting down on them. The net result? This thing will pull about 1G in braking force if you jump all over the brake pedal. Now that is prodigious. The better news is that the whole system is basically fade-free because of its size. That means if you do use this car to capability and you need the brakes, they're going to work. Perhaps the single biggest improvement is found in the transmission. Gone is that wonky single-clutch automated manual in favour of a delightfully smooth twin-clutch design that snicks up and down the gears with silky precision. No herky-jerky operation. Thank goodness. This time around, the performance is superb and the shifts are as blindingly quick as they are smooth. This M5 has got multiple personalities and the driver can set it up exactly as he likes. Now, to begin with, if I'm driving around town, I have everything in comfort. The engine, the transmission are in lazy mode, the steering and suspension is easy, and the stability control system's on. Now, if I decide to ramp things up, you go into iDrive and you can set up this M button. That means that I've now got sport suspension, sport steering, a more aggressive transmission, and I've got the M view in the head-up display. But then, when you want to go to a track, quite simply flip it over, select the M2 button. That then engages the MDM or M dynamic mode. This thing allows the back end to step out before the nanny corrects things. As I say, three very different personalities. The first is comfortable, the second is fast, the third, well, let's just say it's hyper.
Regardless of the setup chosen, the M5 delivers astounding road manners. It's comfortable and accommodating in the comfort mode, yet there's little body roll, and the steering has a pleasantly tight feel to it. Opt for the firmer settings and the damping and steering become much crisper without killing the ride comfort. It comes together such that keeping the M5 on the driver's intended line is remarkably easy, in spite of the cornering forces it generates when it's pushed to the limit. It is a large sedan that weighs 1,990 kilograms, yet the driver would never know from the feedback and precision of the drive.
The M5 has always been one of my favorite cars, and purely and simply because you get two very different cars
in one delightful package. It is a 5-passenger sedan with enough trunk space and comfort to treat the family well. Yet you drop the family off, go to the racetrack, and this car in stock form will kick butt. It is blindingly fast. Now, if there is a bit of a pet peeve, it is that the exhaust note just isn't what I expected. I want more snap and snarl. I think I hear aftermarket exhaust.